To me, Nan Goldin is not only a friend, but she also is really one of the greatest artists, I think, of our time.
I feel like when I'm looking at Nan's portraits, that I'm seeing things that only Nan could see and show. And I love that in her work.
I can appreciate the formal quality of the work and the sort of riveting beauty of it, but I also feel it's the intimacy in which she kind of pulls the viewer as well as the subject together. It's sort of this incredible amalgamation of spying and also being intimate with the subjects at the same time.
She's someone who really loves to look at art, you know, to talk about art and help other photographers with their work. And she's happiest when she's in the museum, you know. So in that way, she's sort of an artist's artist.
When I made a promise to myself that if Bush stole the election from Gore in 2000, I would leave. And I left. But it had no effect on the politics of America.
You're sitting there yakking right in my face. I guess I'm going
there we go. I have this theory that children have just come from somewhere and they know much more than we do. They know exactly what's going on. And then the socialization starts, of course, and the child's ruined for life. But those first 4 years, when you don't have memory, is, I think, when children are still in touch with where they came from.
We're launching our icons collection. This was such an important launch for us because also this is launching the Jimmy Choo Foundation, which is going to be working on women's rights. And so we wanted someone very special to shoot this. Nan Goldin is one of the greatest living photographers that we have today. She's an incredible, fine photographic artist. I love her vision. I love the way she sees things. When she shoots something, it's not posed. It's very different from a normal fashion shoot.
I'm not modest about it. I think in the 80s I created a sea change in photography, that I gave people permission to show their own lives as valuable and as valid as all the other documentary of people they didn't know. And I think I opened a door. Lots of people came to me and said it helped their lives. They were able to move to New York and get away from societies or places they lived where they didn't feel any comfort or any identification. And it was never about marginalization. We were the world. We had our own world and we cared about each other.
Oh,
go away.
Moon!
Ready for your close-up?